I've known him since I was a little girl. Well, I knew of him. I don't think he noticed me. It's so cliche. He was the popular guy and I was the weird little geeky girl in the corner that nobody cared about. Let's just say I matured well. He lived on the other side of the street, just a couple of doors down. I could see his house from my window. I used to watch him catching the school bus in the morning and playing with his dog on the lawn. It was very sweet. At some point, I can't remember exactly when, he moved house. I didn't think about him for a while. So our first date happened by chance, actually. It was the first time I'd seen him in years. I'd been stood up and was sat on my own feeling sorry for myself. And out of nowhere, he comes through the door, recognises me and comes over to chat. We ended up spending the whole evening together. It was cute, but I was just so nervous. I think he was too. He went to hold my hand and spilt a glass of wine down me. It was fine. I laughed. I didn't mind. I was just happy to be with him. It felt so natural, and the conversation flowed so well. Almost like he knew what I was going to say before I said it. He turned up out of the blue to my door one day. We got in the car and drove for what seemed like years, as I sat watching the world go by. We stopped next to a woodland, and even though it was the middle of winter and the trees had no leaves, it was beautiful. So peaceful. As we ventured through the trees, we came to this little clearing where he'd set up our own little hideaway, where we escaped the world and just be us. He'd somehow remembered my birthday. He turned on the radio and we just danced. I was just spinning, feeling more free than ever before. Then he grabbed me and kissed me. Oh, it was the most romantic thing in the world. It was my sister's wedding. Oh, she looked beautiful. She wore a lace, ivory dress and a beaming smile. Her husband wore one that matched. They were announced husband and wife, and he squeezed my hand the tiniest bit tighter. Maybe I had imagined it, but I'm sure that means something. It was such a beautiful ceremony. And it made me think, this could be us one day. My family loved him. Of course they did. Because everyone did. Everyone could see how perfect he was for me, gliding through the room as if he were walking on clouds. I felt like I was walking on clouds. He opened my eyes and made me a better person. He's seen it all, and yet he still accepted me for who I am. So why did he have to ruin it? My mum meant the world to me. He knew that. She was my entire support system. She just knew how to fix everything. He promised he'd be there for me. But he was nowhere to be seen. 1 year without her. And I still dread waking up every day. Now I'm not sure I ever really had him. Who could be so selfish?
Did he ever really love me?
Am I not enough? How could she say that in front of me? Could she not see that we were together?
He doesn't look at me like he used to. He seems distant. He could have anyone he wants. Why would he want me? I feel disgusting. I can't believe I ever let him touch me. I just need to wash it all away.
He's so inconsiderate. So selfish. What possesses a person to hurt someone in this way?
But I thought we had something. I'm spontaneous. And I'm full on. But it's only because I'm so passionate. He was the only one who could really get inside my mind. I can't give up yet, though. This is meant to be. I'll show him I'm the perfect girlfriend. This was the first meal we had together, remember? Oh, you were a messy eater then. But dare I say it, you're even worse now. I wish you could just be the person that I want you to be, who you were in the beginning. Something changed between us. Maybe I'm better off never thinking about you again. Just get you out of my mind. Just stop thinking about you. Just something to get you away. Out of my mind. Just get out! It was brutal. This whole thing was taking over my mind, and I couldn't handle it anymore. So I snapped. And that's why I'm here. To tell you what I've done. It all just happened so quickly, which I guess is the way things always happen for me. I watched the life draining from him as his soul left his body.
Why did you do it, Daisy?
Because he doesn't love me.
Who's he, Daisy?
He's the one! He's the love of my life!
It's okay, Daisy. We have someone here to see you.
Daisy, darling, why don't we get you home?
It's the 3rd of March, 2017, at 1855, and this case is now closed.